Thanks for tuning into the channel today, and a big welcome to all the new subscribers which have joined the CT channel. And first off, I'd like to say I did a review on this the other day, a round town review, to give you an idea of how the bike performed around town. Only problem was I hadn't connected the mic, and the review was a write-off. So what we'll do is get on this bike, and I think we'll call this from now on, we'll call this our bike, because naturally a lot of you are waiting for your bike to arrive, so I don't mind sharing my bike, so we'll class this one as ours, so we'll go for a ride on our bike, and naturally when you get your bike, it'll be classed, that bike will be classed as yours, so we'll get on this one, take it for a run. I'll try to give you my impressions of what this bike's like to a ride around town, and we might go down past an area like as if we're going on a type of a coffee run, and there's that magpie again running down along the track, so let's get on it. Once again, first time to the bike. They're a pretty easy little bike to get onto, so they bray in at 120 kilos. That seat height is about 800 mils off the ground. It's a fairly comfortable little seat to sit on. I did read reports prior to getting this bike that the Super Cub guys that sat on that had problems sitting on that seat, and they kept on sitting towards the back of the seat, but I don't know, at 5'9" weighing in at 80 kilos, I haven't had any problems in that area, so I can sit on the seat all right. One thing I like about the bike, you can come out here and just turn the key and it starts first go, so that's always a good plus. You know, just because you buy a new bike doesn't mean they really want to start, or I find they don't. I've had plenty of new bikes that don't want to start, or don't want to start well, but apart from that, this is a pretty neat looking bike, and I think if you were just buying this bike to run around town, you'd be very happy with it that way. And so let's get on it, see how she goes. And I've got a habit now of doing the old step through trick, like so. Might just whip these gloves on, key her in. More importantly, I suppose I better get this camera angle right. Hopefully we'll get that right. And we'll kick her over. And being a Honda, naturally it starts first go. All you've got, I'll just get in the shade of it. All you've got there is your, you're looking at this for the first time. All you've got is your petrol gauge up top, your speedo, your total mileage, and your little trip meter there showing at the bottom. At the moment the ABS light's on, but once I get to around about 10 kilometres an hour, that'll reset itself. It'll go out. This is a very strange gearbox in this particular bike for Australia. Neutral's right at the bottom, which I'm at now naturally, and then after that I press down on the heel and that'll get me first, which I'm in now, and after that I press on the heel to get all gears to go up, which I am finding a little bit hard to get used to, but that's taken a little bit of effort because I've never had a bike that does that sort of thing. And you know, it's a bit of a drama that way, but let's go for a run, see how she goes. Okay, the light's out now, see, as soon as I hit 10 k's. So we're heading on down here nicely. One thing about this bike, like I said, it's about 800 mil seat height. Come down to here now. I'm virtually flat foot when I come to the corner here now. Swing around to the right. I think it takes a little while to get used to the gear change on this one, and I think the secret is throttle off and a slow change. You know, you're not, let's just say if he wants to stop, a slow change, and you're not doing it like Speedy Gonzales. And apart from that, it'll rumble on that quite well. So even when you come up to here, and I'm going to go right, back off, and then, yeah, go back slow. I've had this trouble, I've had a bit of a jerkiness in the gear change. It's got a fair bit of torque too, so it'll pull down low in the gears. So I've been making a bit of mistakes on the riding of this compared to other bikes, and now it is a lot more pleasurable to ride in that area. Now, the seat is a little bit on the firm side, and what I might do before I go any further, just in case, I might just move the camera up a tad, because, you know, there's just so many times you can go out and do a film. So we're in neutral. Hopefully that'll be better. So, we're off again. See, I forgot I was on this bike and thought I was on one of my other bikes and just went back into that thing. So, we'll just leave that mistake in. So if you back off as you're doing it, you'll find that it runs along quite nice. Now here I am cruising along now at close on 50 kilometres an hour. That's 30 mile in the old scale. Running into a fairly good headwind. It's just battling along there. I'm not even battling along, just cruising along with no drama whatsoever. So overall the pickup on this bike is pretty good around town when you sort of get into it. I find the riding position quite comfortable too. Handlebars are nice. Bike's a little bit affected by the wind. At this speed, very little to no vibration. Got a nice loud horn on it too. And even in direct sunlight, what I'm at now, the speedo very easy to read, no trouble at all reading that one. And the gear change just goes back nice and easy. And that's got a bit of pickup in the gears when you go back to second there, in the third, in the fourth. So, you know, it's very good in that area too. Handles the bumps nicely. We'll head up this way. It's just a little bit odd with that change, neutral at the bottom and four up. Just takes that little while to get used to compared to if you're on the bikes year after year and your normal pattern, neutral, one down, four up, five up, and you've got to get used to that one. One thing I will say about this bike, it's got really good steering and it's very nimble, so you can really see a pothole or anything coming up and you can maneuver your way out of it, no trouble whatsoever. In case you're wondering about something else, the brakes, the really good brakes on it. The ABS system on the front's nice. So for around town running, or you know, your local run to the coffee shop, it's got adequate power. You can keep up with the cars, no trouble. Might just show you something up here while we're at it. I'll just pull up around this corner. Just leave the bike running, it's just running near neutral. Just take a look at this. See this sign here, it says Mother's Choice Goldenia Billy Tree. Well, it's hard to believe, but back in 1970 or 50 years ago, I used to do the mail run here in this exact area. So that was 50 years back. And that sign was here then 50 years ago. So it's still hanging around now, especially the original blue. It's faded a bit now over the years, but still 50 years later, still there. Nothing much changed. So they may have did a little bit of restoration on the bottom part of it, but the original top part, Mother's Choice, back in 1950, back in 1970, I mean, Mrs. Grayling owned this store. But that's the way it goes. We might just have another bit of look at, I'll see the bike there now. But anyway, we'll travel on this. Once again, using the old step through trick. It's good to have the side stand. Back in gear. Away we go. Look at that, pickup's real good. And then when you rev her out a bit, it doesn't take long to get to 30 mile an hour or 50 k's. And when you're on a 120 kilo bike, it's quite nimble. That. And the torque, for that you can get down to 30 k's or 18 mile an hour in third. And then you can just rev her out. But it won't be long before I've got to put a bit of gas in it. So yeah, overall, I'm sort of enjoying a little bit of run around on this particular bike, and I think if you buy one of these and you want to run up to the local coffee shop or just do it around town, this is my first real test of the bike around town, and there's no qualms on it whatsoever. This bike's got adequate power to run with traffic around town. And not only that, it's got good brakes. Look at that. And you can take off good. Give it a in second. That's almost 30 mile an hour in second. Might keep plugging it along here. So if you work on that gear change like I mentioned earlier, back off the throttle and do a slow shift with that auto or semi-auto on the clutch side, whatever they'd like to call it, you'll find that it's not as jerky. One thing you have to do, watch if you do come into it a bit rough with that change, you might have a little bit of a rear wheel skip. I've done that a few times, but I think all these go with the territory, and you know, you'll get used to it after a while. Yeah, if you go slow, and if you rev her out, either way you look at it, and you still have to always take into account, they're only 9 horsepower, so they're not going to be any huge powerhouse, but as far as getting you A to B, or over a long distance, you know, they'll do it, so, and they'll do it well. Like I said in a couple of other videos, you might even get a job later on delivering the mail. Or then again, you might not, it's hard to say. Later on I might actually take it out on a night run and just see how good the LED headlights are. That might be interesting. Somebody mentioned on one of my comments that they'd like to see me take it into a little bit harder place to ride it. You know, that where I've been is just where you could take a four-wheel drive or something like that. So I might run it out into the scrub, in amongst the trees, and see how it performs in amongst there. So that'll be a clip I can put together on that. But at the moment, if you're after one of these and you want to run it at just for around town use, I think you'd be quite happy with it. I'm surprised how well you can see the odometer, speedo, instrumentation, whatever you want to look at, in direct sunlight. No trouble at all reading. It's really good. And overall, the suspension does handle the bumps pretty good. See, that was a bit abrupt in the gear change, but swung around the corner nice. But that fourth change then was pretty good. I think it's just up more when you're on this bike, you just got to think about more what you're doing. And after a while you just get used to that side of it. And that's a bit of a problem when you've got different bikes you're getting on and off all the time. So it'd be just something that'll improve. So we go back to third, take your time, see, that was a good change. Might just swing around here. Look at that, it's just pulling really low.